Grand rising, y'all. Today we standing on my father's business.
But you should have known it. I wasn't going.
All right, y'all. So God told me to come back with Proverbs because Proverbs have such strong meat in it, and I just love Proverbs. I mean, I really actually love all the chapters of the Bible. You know what I'm saying? So let's just start with Proverbs chapter 1, okay? Just so to give you a little bit of insight about Proverbs, right? All right, so this is out of the King James Version Bible. This is Proverbs chapter 1, and wow, Proverbs is right after Psalms. So, you know what? We're going to start with Psalms 148. Praise ye the Lord. Praise ye the Lord from the heavens. Praise him in the heights. Praise ye him, all his angels. Praise ye him, all his hosts. Praise ye him, sun and moon. Praise him, all ye stars of light. Praise him, ye heavens of heavens, and ye waters that be above the heavens. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for he commanded and they were created. He have also established them forever and ever. He have made a decree which shall not pass. Praise the Lord from the earth, ye dragons and all the deeps. Fire and hail, snow and vapors, stormy and fulfilling his word. Mountains and all hills, fruitful trees and all cedars, beasts and all cattle, creeping things and the flying fowl, kings of the earth, all the people, princes, all the judges of the earth, both young men and maidens, old men and children, let them praise the name of the Lord, for his name alone is excellent. His glory is above the earth and the heaven. He also exalted the horn of his people, the praise of all his saints, even of the children of Israel, a people near unto him. Praise ye the Lord. God, I like that. All right, y'all. So we're going to start off in Proverbs. We're going to transition to Proverbs chapter 1, verse 1. The Proverbs of Solomon, the son of David, the king of Israel. To know wisdom and instruction, to perceive the words of understanding, to receive the instruction of wisdom, justice, and judgment, and equity. Wow. We all be wanting some equity, you know what I'm saying? To give subtlety to the simple, to the young man knowledge and discretion. A wise man will hear and will increase learning, and a man of understanding shall attain unto wise counsels. To understand a proverb and the interpretation, the words of the wise and their dark sayings. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge, but fools despise wisdom and instruction. My son, hear the instruction of thy father, and forsake not the law of thy mother, for they shall be an ornament of grace unto thy head, and chains about thy neck. My son, if sinners entice thee, consent thou not. If they say, come with us, let us lay wait for blood. Let us lurk privily for the innocent without cause. Let us swallow them up alive as the grave, and whole as those that go down into the pit. We shall find all precious substance. We shall fill our houses with spoil. Cast in thy lot among us. Let us all have one purse. My son, walk not thou in the way with them. Refrain thy foot from their path. For their feet run to evil and make haste to shed blood. Surely in vain the net is spread in the sight of any bird. And they lay wait for their own blood. They lurk privily for their own lives. So are the ways of everyone that is greedy of gain, which taketh away the life of his owners thereof. Wisdom crieth without. She uttereth her voice in the streets. All right, now when it says wisdom crieth, wisdom crieth without. She uttereth her voice in the streets. Wisdom is a feminine. Even though it's a feminine spirit, like a woman's spirit, but there's no, you wouldn't call it a woman, it's a feminine spirit. That's why it says wisdom crieth out. She uttereth her voice in the streets. She crieth in the chief place of concourse, in the openings of the gates. In the city she uttereth her words, saying, how long, ye simple ones, will you love simplicity? And the scorners delight in their scorning, and fools hate knowledge. So this is her saying, now mind you, it's not a woman. It's just a, it's a feminine. It's a feminine spirit. There's a difference, right? So she's basically saying, like, how long will y'all be without knowledge? Like, I'm sitting over here. I'm sitting real pretty. I'm sitting real pretty with wisdom. You know what I'm saying? I have the key. Like, wisdom is saying to us, right? That this is to us. Now, I'm going to reread this again. I want you to pretend in your head, imagine in your head that this is like a woman that's telling you something. So now I'm going to reread that just, you know, so you can have a little bit better understanding on that. Wisdom crieth without. She uttereth her voice in the streets. She crieth in the chief place of the concourse, in the openings of the gates. In the city she uttereth her words, saying, how long, ye simple ones, will you love simplicity? And the scorners delight in their scorning, and fools hate knowledge. Turn ye you at my reproof. Behold, I will pour out my spirit unto you. I will make known my words unto you. God, I apologize for stopping, but wisdom, I need you. Y'all, I named my dog Mr. Wisdom. I named my dog Wisdom because you need wisdom in this earth, right? God, we just call forth the supernatural wisdom that we need. All right. Okay. So turn you at my reproof. Behold, I will pour out my spirit unto you. I will make known my words unto you, because I have called and ye refused. I have stretched out my hand and no man regarded. But ye have set at naught all my counsel and with none of my reproof. So right there, what she's saying is, I tried to come to you, but you didn't want me. I tried to come to you, but you didn't want me. Like, to people that just don't want wisdom. You know what I'm saying? Okay, so, but ye have set at naught all my counsel and with none of my reproof. I also will laugh at your calamity. That's what wisdom say. Whenever you go through something, if you would have gained the wisdom, you would have been able to, you know, get through it, right? Or grow through it, as you may say. But she says that, I also will laugh at your calamity. And that was because you didn't accept the wisdom, right? I will mock when you fear, when your fear cometh. Like, she said she's going to mock when your fear cometh, because you didn't seek her out, because you didn't receive the wisdom, the spirit. You didn't receive it. So when you're scared, when you're alone, you don't even have wisdom to figure out how you can get through something, right? When your fear cometh as desolation and your destruction cometh as a whirlwind, when distress and anguish come upon you, then shall they call upon me, but I will not answer. They shall seek me early, but they shall not find me. Have you seek to find wisdom today? God, am I seeking wisdom the right way? God, because I don't want her to laugh at my calamity. I receive wisdom. I receive wisdom, wisdom, wisdom. Come on to me. Wisdom, I receive wisdom. Holy Spirit, come on up in here. Holy Spirit, we invite you in. If you haven't invited the Holy Spirit in just yet, go ahead and invite the Holy Spirit into your space. Holy Spirit, we invite you in. All that are under the sound of my voice, we invite you in. Holy Spirit, we invite you in. For that they hated knowledge and did not choose the fear of the Lord. God, Lord, I need help, Lord. God, please, Lord, I'm gonna have to start searching you out for fear. Sometimes you just don't even know what to say, man. God, when you be reading the word, man, you just be like, man. Just make you scratch your head, but I'm gonna keep going. They would none of my counsel. They despise all of my reproof. Therefore shall they eat of the fruit of their own way and be filled with their own devices. Devices? I'm talking on a device right now. Okay, so the Bible knew about the devices. That's how you know this word is real. Okay. For the turning away of the simple shall slay them, and the prosperity of fools shall destroy them. But whosoever hearken unto me shall dwell safely and shall be quiet from fear of evil. Wisdom, I want to dwell with you. Okay, my son, now this is chapter 2. My son, if thou wilt receive my words and hide my commandments with thee, so that thou incline thine ear unto wisdom and apply thine heart to understanding, yea, if thou criest after knowledge and liftest up thy voice for understanding, if thou seekest her as silver and searchest for her as for hidden treasures, then shalt thou understand the fear of the Lord and find the knowledge of God. For the Lord giveth wisdom. Out of his mouth cometh knowledge and understanding. He layeth up sound wisdom for the righteous. He is a buckler to them that walk uprightly. He keepeth the paths of judgment and preserveth the way of his saints. Then shalt thou understand righteousness and judgment and equity. Yeah, every good path. I mean, he even said, yeah, comma. Every good path. I mean, you know, like, yeah. You know what I'm saying? When wisdom entereth into thine heart and knowledge is pleasant unto thy soul, discretion shall preserve thee, understanding shall keep thee, to deliver thee from the way of the evil man, from the man that speaketh froward things. Okay, froward means, you know, I looked it up years ago, but I kind of forgot. But I kind of somewhat know what, you know what? Let me just look it up. ASMR. Boom, I put the scripture right there for you, baby. All right, I mean, the definition, right? The definition. Yeah, the definition. Who leave the paths of uprightness to walk in the ways of darkness. Wait, to deliver thee from the way of the evil man, from the man that speaketh forward things, who leave the paths of uprightness to walk in the ways of darkness, who rejoice to do evil and delight in forwardness of the wicked, whose ways are crooked and they forward in their paths, to deliver thee from the strange woman. To deliver thee from the strange woman. Okay, so this right here. So that's what I'm saying. Proverbs is fire. Like, you like start with Proverbs. If you're going to start with something, if you haven't picked up the Bible and started reading it yet, start with Proverbs. Because it's simple. It's not simple. It's simple, but it's fire. It's simple, but it's power. It's simple, but it's understanding. Like, you know what I'm saying? So, trying to see if the kids was up. Who rejoice to do evil and delight in forwardness of the wicked, whose ways are crooked and they forward in their paths, to deliver thee from the strange woman, even from the stranger which flattereth with her words, which forsaketh the guide of her youth and forgetteth the covenant of her God. For her house inclineth unto death and her paths unto the dead. Now, this is talking about a woman who is, you know, a whore. Like, it's a whore, and she don't love God. She don't know, you know, she forsaketh the covenant. She forgot about the covenant with God. For her house inclineth unto death and her paths unto the dead. None that go into her, like have sex with her, return again. Neither take they hold of their paths of life, that thou mayest walk in the way of good men and keep the paths of righteous. For the upright shall dwell in the land, and the perfect shall remain in it. But the wicked shall be cut off from the earth, and the transgressors shall be rooted out of it. Lord Jesus. I mean, I just feel like my life just changed so drastically, Lord. Like, I just really just hope that somebody was able to receive that today. All right, y'all. So, we done with Proverbs. So, now we're going to go with our daily decree. My little raggedy paper. I'm going to keep this paper too. The kids done spilled. My big daddy done spilled coffee on it. The kids done wrote on it. But who cares? This is a daily declaration. I decree Ephesians 3:20 over my life. God will do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that I ask or think. Because I honor him. His blessings will chase me down and overtake me. I will be in the right place at the right time. People will go out of their way to be good to me. I am surrounded by God's favor. I am am surrounded by God's favor. I am surrounded by God's favor. And this is my declaration. Amen. All right, y'all. Oh, y'all hear that? Mr. Wisdom decided he want to get out this morning. Just flee out into the dang on. The kids open up the door and this man going to go running out. So let me go get this dog, y'all. I'll be right back. Good to see you. Come here. Y'all, this is Mr. Wisdom. He's a hot dog. Mr. Wisdom! All right, get down because you stink. All right, so now we're about to go to Supernatural Decrees. Now, this is from out of Lanika Scott's The Supernatural Wealth Transfer book. Don't judge my book. It's just, you know, it's been through, you know, all kind of stuff. This is her right here, Lanika Scott. ASMR, ASMR. All right, so now, Father God, I repent if I was not supposed to do that just now. God, just help me to stay on task and to not be playing around. I just want to have fun with, you know, your word and, you know what I'm saying? That's all. Okay, God. Okay, let's get it. Let's do it. All right. I receive supernatural freedom over my life. 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 Confess these over your life every day. You will see these words come to pass and things will literally change for you in the natural. I pray that every reader will walk into these supernatural declarations. These are powerful decrees. The word decree means an official statement that something must happen. Job 22:28, thou shalt also decree a thing and it shall be established unto thee and the light shall shine upon thy ways. All right. 1 John 5:14 says, and this is the confidence that we have toward him, that if we ask anything according to his will, he hears us. All right, y'all, join in with me. I receive supernatural freedom over my life. I receive supernatural freedom over my life. I receive supernatural freedom over my life. Yay, supernatural freedom. Confess these over your life every day. You will see these words come to pass and things will literally change for you in the natural. I pray that every listener and or reader will walk into these supernatural declarations. These are powerful decrees. The word decree means an official statement that something must happen. Listen, Walker Foundation family, as I said before, we are standing on our Father's business. Listen, y'all make it a great day and have a, what they be saying, have a blessed day on purpose. Bye-bye. Baby, you should know this.
I ain't going. I ain't blowing no smoke. I mean, I've been sober. But you should have known it. I wasn't going.